Boston Bruins currently have a massive problem when it comes to who's going to be our third defensive pairing heading into the 2022 playoffs. For the majority of the season, the defensive pairings have been set in stone, maybe inserting in that seventh man occasionally due to injury or just needing a change of pace, but for the most part, it's been a very consistent combination of any of our top six, that be it Matt Grzelcyk and Charlie McAvoy, Mike Reilly, Brandon Carlo, Derick Forbort, and Connor Clifton. Early on in the season, we had that rotation of Zboril, Vaakalainen, and John Moore. Zboril got injured and he's been out the entire season. John Moore was never really a guy you could trust in the long term, but Vaakalainen looked like he might actually solidify a spot in the top six. Throw all of that out the window because we traded away John Moore and Vaakalainen to Anaheim in exchange for Hampus, Lindholm, which did really help bolster up our top four, but we lost a few good guys in the process. We also acquired Josh Brown from Ottawa, and now we have a new rotation of guys to test out. Lindholm was an immediate plug-in to our top pairing, and that meant that Bruce Cassidy had to make a decision. Even before Josh Brown got into Boston, Cassidy had the choice between Connor Clifton or Mike Reilly, and the initial choice was to leave out Reilly and to go with Forbort Clifton as that third pairing. And it was working out fairly decently. That was until we played Toronto on March 29th and lost 6-4. The stats might not show it, with Clifton being a -2 and Forbort being at an even plus minus during that game, but the pairing looked absolutely atrocious, and it caused Cassidy to say that he wanted to mix things up and get everybody involved. From that game on, so far it's been a consistent four-man rotation of Forbort, Reilly, Clifton, and Josh Brown, with just about every combination of the four defensemen being used so far. The problem with all of this is now we only have a solid top two lines. I can't remember a time the Bruins have had not one but two spots up for grabs and are just rotating guys out constantly. Statistically, when you look at the potential pairings, it really paints the picture that there's really only two options we should be going with. Now, Josh Brown hasn't been with us long enough yet to really see what he's all about, but the way I personally see it is that he's already the last guy in rotation anyways. So then you have three possible combinations to go with: Forbort Clifton, Forbort Reilly, or Reilly Clifton. The Forbort Reilly combination is the least used by the Bruins so far this season. They actually only paired up during one game, 38 total minutes together on the season, and it's safe to say that we will never see it again. If they had played a full 60 minutes together, they had a projected goals against of 4.22 and a shots against Corsi of 65. Corsi is simply tracking how many shots a player gives up when they're on the ice. That can be a shot on goal, a shot that completely misses the net, or even a blocked shot. And Forbort Reilly were projected to give up 65 over the course of a full game. Just as a comparison, even though the sample size is small, the Lindholm McAvoy pairing has a 49 shots against Corsi per 60 minutes. Not very good from Forbort Reilly. The second best option we have is Reilly Clifton, which have a surprising amount of time played together this season. 170 minutes of time on ice together, they're averaging 53 shots against per 60 minutes and 2.21 goals against as well. That's not amazing, but it's not the worst thing we could put out there. Both of them definitely have some speed to them and can fly up the ice with the puck. Reilly has always been a pass first guy, but it seems like recently he's been willing to shoot a bit more. Clifton can definitely score some goals as well, but when it comes down to it, the combination isn't that promising, especially going into the playoffs. Scarily enough, the best choice we still have is Forbort Clifton. They have a respectable 1.89 goals against per 60 minutes and only allow 44 shots against them over the course of a full game. They by far have the most experience together, with over 45 games or 425 plus minutes of time on ice together. Forbort has been in a really bad slump, but it seems like he genuinely should be that fifth defenseman. He's a huge body and he's had his bright spots throughout this season, especially very early on when he was taking shots and scoring goals. Clifton has been with the Bruins already 4 seasons. He's been a consistent guy playing, and even a lot during the playoffs. He played the first 6 games of the finals versus St. Louis in 2019, posting 1 goal, 1 assist, although he was -1 during those games. I think you have to trust Clifton here heading into the playoffs. He's had a rough few weeks at it, and so has Forbort, but statistically it is the best pairing we could go with. Reilly is never a bad option to throw in there, and Josh Brown could surprise us down the stretch. Having trust in 4 guys with 2 spots available isn't that bad of a situation to have, but at the same time, it is quite concerning the lack of urgency all 4 defensemen are showing trying to secure themselves a spot in this lineup. Hopefully Lindholm comes back soon, hopefully Grzelcyk can stay healthy throughout the playoffs, as well as one of those 4 players can secure themselves that 5th spot, because myself and most Bruins fans are starting to get slightly nervous. There's less than 10 games remaining, and there's no sight of a consistent bottom pairing.